our latest evicted housemate, Albie Casino. Hi, Albie.
Hi, Tony. Thank you for having me. Yes, so good to be back in the outside world. I miss you, housemates. I know you can't watch this, but yeah. I just want to say it.
Thank you for saying yes right away.
No problem, Tony. It's like, I'm actually a fan. You know, yeah. I have a small podcast also, so yeah, I like to watch on people who I admire, so I can take some tips. You know what I mean?
Parang iba na yung confidence mo ngayon, Albie. Parang mas secure ka na sa sarili mo, mas kilala mo na yung sarili mo.
Thank you, Ate Tony. But like, siguro it's because I feel so much love now. Sa 12-year career ko sa showbiz, I never really felt loved as an artist, as a person. You know what I mean? Of course, the love of my family and my friends always there. But when you're a public figure, kasi yung paano ka tanggapin ng public, it really plays with your head, diba? Kung hindi naman ako, if I was just working in an office job and, diba, like I was getting bashed online, I don't think I would care. Mm-hmm. But my job is to be in the public eye.
Public figure.
So, of course, yung kung paano ka tignan ng public, it really affected me.
Parang from a new cutie, teeny bopper, young actor, biglang you experienced this big controversy. Tapos nag-stick na yung bad reputation na yun sa'yo all throughout the 12 years in your career. Paano mo hinandle yun?
At first, Tony, it was really hard. Especially when I would be taping. Because, so like, I just had this anxiety na everyone hates me talaga, all my co-actors. So I would always, if it was guesting man yan, or ASAP, or regular shows, hindi ako masyado nakikipaghalubilo sa mga ibang artista. Kasi feel ko like, these guys have an idea of me.
Pero bakit mo pa rin kinontinue yung showbiz?
Siguro dahil ayokong ipakita sa kanila na tinalo niyo ako. You know what I mean? I feel like if I quit, if I stop doing it, parang sa kanila, it would be a victory for them na.
Diba? Or parang tinalo ka ng controversy.
Tinalo ako ng perceptions ng mga tao. I didn't want to show people that it was affecting me, even if it really was. Diba? Like, my favorite Bible verse is, "No weapon formed against me shall prosper." So I feel like that really sums up, like, my attitude. Na I feel that even if there's people who want to destroy me or, like, bring me down, at the end, it's not gonna prosper.
Saan mo nakuha yun, yung ganung ugali?
Feel ko lang, it's just because I don't like to quit. And
hindi ka quitter.
Yeah, so, you know, I just took it day by day, step by step talaga.
Siyempre, at 18 years old, pag dumaan ka sa ganung klaseng pagsubok, na ang laki, di ba? Tapos ang daming opinion. Tapos ang daming sinasabi against you. Ano yung sinasabi lagi sa'yo ng mami mo?
Alam mo naman to, Ate Tony, like, kung ano nararamdaman mo, times 10 yung nararamdaman ng mother.
Mas masakit.
Mas masakit talaga. So, siguro nakuha ko rin yung strength ko from her because most of the time, parang walang nangyari in our house, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Parang pinapakita, no, it's all normal, don't worry about it, don't worry about what they're saying. She would always just tell me to, one, keep quiet about it because it wouldn't look good nga if, diba, kasi I'm a man and then she's a woman. So, like she said, just be quiet. One day the truth will prevail. You'll get vindicated. You'll be vindicated one day. That's all she kept on saying, diba? But of course, at that time, ang hirap. Kailan yung one day na yan, diba? It's been 6 months, it's been a year, it's been 2 years, it's been 10 years.
2016, you were vindicated when the truth came out, diba?
I guess, but like, if really, I feel like they dragged me publicly, diba? They said all these nasty things publicly. They dragged my family publicly. They ruined my family name. But like, of course, like to this day, I don't have a Twitter because I don't wanna get the hate, diba? I mean, diba? It's easy to say, wag mo pansinin yung mga hate comments, pero it's different when it's all you see.
Yeah.
Iba talaga siya. So I don't have a Twitter. I had to hide my Instagram for a while. That's why my username's TheStallion09, not Albie Casino. Because I was trying to hide from all of the hate before. And then the vindication came from her sister on a podcast. It wasn't even them. It was just a slip up. And what if Ademax never went on the show? What if they never asked about me on the show? Then it would have never happened. Right? It was just a slip of the moment thing.
So when the truth came out, anong naramdaman mo? Ilang taong ka na nun?
Mga 24 na ako nun.
So 18, na-experience mo yung controversy. 24, lumabas yung totoo.
Yeah.
Anong naramdaman mo?
To be honest, it wasn't even... I didn't feel like it was the vindication I was expecting. That segment where she said that it wasn't enough for me to feel vindicated from all the years of the bashing, all of the news articles that were written about me, all the lost work. I felt like I needed more to be vindicated.
Mm-hmm. So you feel like hindi ka pa vindicated ngayon?
Back then, now I really just try to push it behind me. Like I said, I realize now, I fully accept the fact that forever, for the rest of my life, kasama na yan sa pangalan ko.
So at 28 years old, what's your biggest regret in life?
That's a hard question. Wow. Every day naman mayroon tayong mga regrets. Like, if it's just about PBB, now that I see how much people were supporting me while I was inside the house, I regret that I wanted to leave so early, diba? Mm. I feel like I let them down, all of my supporters. And then it's so selfish. Like, nahihirapan lang ako sa loob, so I wanted to get out, diba? So, gusto ko na umalis.
But gusto mo na umalis? Sabi mo hindi ka quitter.
Yeah, but like, I was happy that I got evicted because then that's not quitting, man. I just lost the show.
Gusto mo na umalis kasi?
Alam mo, ito, Ate Tony, yung pinakamahirap sa akin dun was the fact that we couldn't shower whenever we wanted. Kasi may shower call eh. Diba? And then like, ang dami namang oras na walang ginagawa sa bahay. Kuya, ba't bawal ako maligo? Diba? Nag-bot ako kanina.
May rules eh.
I'm smelling weird na.
Rules kasi. Uh-oh. So yun ang tanong, bakit ka nag-yes sa PBB? And paano ka nag-yes sa PBB?
Well, nung una gusto ko nga mag-yes kasi, like I said, I wanted to change public perception of me at first. And I wanted to show people na I'm more than the issues, diba? I like to think I'm a funny guy, easy to get along with. Pero pagpasok ko nga dun, parang naging baliktad pa eh. You know what I mean? Like, what I got naman from it was I got to know myself so much more. And that's priceless, diba?
Ano yung natutunan mo more about yourself?
So I guess like, one, I may be no filter and outspoken, but that doesn't mean na I can say whatever I want. I still have to be careful with what I have to say. You know what I mean? I learned that because I went inside the house with some of the housemates na I guess nakakasakit pala yung the way I say things. But like, in my mind, kasi I'm not trying to hurt you, I'm just telling the truth, the truth that I see. But I guess that there's a way to say things na I can be kinder in some of the way that I say things.
Parang you weren't kinder when you said that she was fat now and that you're happy that she's fat. That's why did you say that?
Okay.
Can you explain? Yeah. Why did you say that?
My manager actually told me not to talk about this, but I feel like as a man, I have to. First of all, I really didn't think that it would pick up that much traction. I really honestly didn't think that it would spread like wildfire, what I said. And I know now that I was wrong to say that. And I want to apologize to everybody who was offended by what I had to say. I was in the spur of the moment. I was trying to say something. To be honest, to be completely honest, I wanted to say something that would make her feel bad.
You wanted to say something that would make her feel bad because
of all of the anger that I had, all the pent-up frustration that I had from all of the years. You know what I mean? I felt like this would be a way for me to say something funny and at the same time get back at her for what she did to me. But I didn't expect it to be taken that way. And like I said, I made a mistake then. I know that I made a mistake now. And I want to apologize to everybody else who took that and who took what I said and got offended by it. I really did not mean to offend anybody else. But then again, I really did want to say something to make her feel bad. And that's also wrong.
May galit ka pa.
I don't think mawawala na yan.
So nandun lagi yung galit?
It's not there all the time. If someone brings her up to me, it's not good emotions that I'm thinking. It's not good feelings that I'm feeling. And you know, I'm only human. And like I said, I like to think of myself as unfiltered. And so that's why I said those things. Well, in my mind, I was like, well, they publicly ruined me. They had me assaulted. And they dragged my family name. Like, that's what was going through my head. But like I said, I know now with the platform that I have, I shouldn't be saying those things.
So you regret saying it?
I do. I regret saying it. Like I said, the platform I have now, I want to spread positivity, and with that statement, there was nothing positive about that.
Mm-hmm.
So again, I'm sorry, I made a mistake. And you know, I'm human, guys. I learn day by day.
You were diagnosed with ADHD.
Yeah.
Dyslexia, bata ka pa, you were diagnosed na. But the ADHD?
It was same time. I was going to school at Ateneo at the time. And from what I remember, I couldn't read until I was like 10. Mm. So like the teachers would be, magugulat sila kasi sa quiz, sobrang bagsak ko palagi. Because I was just shotgunning everything. I wasn't reading the questions. But then in oral recitations, I would do so good. So they were like, no problema nitong batang to. So like one day I got pulled out of class. They brought me to some office in Ateneo with a bunch of other kids. And they made us take some tests and stuff. And then there was an oral test after. And then they called my parents in and they were like, you know what I mean? Your son has this. But of course, they went to get a second opinion. And then Ateneo advised my parents to pull me out. They said I couldn't take the standard of education there or something. I don't know. They said that they basically said I would have too much of a hard time in Ateneo. And that's why I went to La Salle for high school. Because I wanted to prove to people that I can do it.
Ano ba talaga pangarap mo, Aldi?
I kind of want to do like a little bit of what Direct Paul's doing, to be honest. When I saw this place the first time I read the script here, I was like, this is so nice. You know what I mean? Make like a little film crew, Stallion Productions maybe. I have a few scripts na in my mind and I've done a few pitches na. So, but then, you know, COVID happened. When I was shooting with Direct Paul in Vancouver, I took a tour of the school of where we were getting the interns and I applied to that school.
Talaga?
Yeah, I got accepted too, but like, you know, I said COVID happened.
Diba 28, marami ka nang natututunan about yourself, tapos pumasok ka sa bahay ni Kuya. Ano yung natutunan mo sa sarili mo nung naging housemate ka?
It's not really more of natutunan ko sa sarili ko. It's things na I knew I had to work on. Pero pagpasok ko, sabi ko, kailangan ko na talagang i-work on these.
Like
my patience for one, diba? My temper for yung pangalawa. And yun nga, like I said, how brashful I am sometimes when I talk. And like, diba, like realizing that the things I say can go a long way because I am a public figure. I learned more when I got out, to be honest. Because when I got out, when I saw all of the fans there, I was like, wow, Albie, I guess you are loved talaga.
Do you think that was a good experience?
I know it was a good experience. I'm forever going to be thankful for the PBB team for letting me be one of the housemates talaga. Like, I told them before when they were in the interview and they asked me, why do you want to do PBB? Sabi ko sa kanila, because I feel like it could change my life.
Paano nabago yung buhay mo?
Like now, like I said, I feel the love now. You know what I mean? I'm not so cynical in the way I think. Because, diba, when you're hated, like, the thoughts you get are not really good thoughts.
Pessimistic.
Yeah, you're pessimist. I call myself that all the time. There's a song called The Pessimist, and I used to listen to it all the time also.
Pessimist ka na?
Yeah.
Pinakikin ka mo pa? Pessimist song.
But now, I feel like I have a new outlook on life.
How do you want people to see you now?
I mean, siguro, I want people to see me for not the controversies or not how I, you know, try to make people laugh. Just look, see me for me, you know. If I do something wrong, call me out for doing something wrong. Because, diba, like I said, I'm human and I learn every day. So if I did wrong things in the past, I want to apologize for them. Because I didn't know any better back then.
Mm-hmm.
And now I do.
When you know better, you will do better,
true.
Diba?
Mm-mm. It's weird kasi parang when I was 18, I was insecure, but at the same time, I was so full of myself also. Kasi, alam mo yun, galing ka sa dibaon na 150 ka per day, and then you'll do a mall show, you get 100K, diba? And you're like, what is this, diba? I can take over the world. Pero, so like now, I'm more realistic, diba? I have to learn how to budget money. That's one thing, I know that now.
What do you think is the biggest mistake that you have committed in your life?
There were a lot of times where I should have listened to my parents. But I thought like I knew better. But before, I would only listen to advice from people who were making more money than me. When you're young and you start making a lot of money, you think that you don't need to listen to anyone, diba? It's like, I'm only 18 and I'm making this much money. Diba? Why would I listen to anybody else? I guess I'm doing something right, diba? Yung nasa utak ko eh. Siguro tama naman ginagawa ko, diba?
Kasi ang yaman ko na, kumikita
na ako ng sobrang laki.
Day ko pa yung iba.
Diba? Like, also, actually, yung teachers ko sa LSGH, isa pa yun, I should have listened to them also. Actually, that was more for them when I said, no, why would I listen to you? Like, I'm paying tuition.
Ganun talaga pag bata ka, no?
Yeah.
Tingin mo parang you own the world.
True.
You are your own boss.
Oo, parang ganun talaga. And like, you know what I mean? You kind of lack a little bit of respect talaga. Especially me back in the day when I was younger.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because I felt like I wasn't getting any respect also at the same time, diba? Mm. I felt like I was being hated on for something that wasn't my fault. And I felt like people were always disrespecting me. So I was like, why would I respect others? People don't even respect me. But then now I realize that respect is earned, not given. So that I made mistakes that caused me to be in a controversy like that. So I had to earn back people's respect. So now I'm trying to do that little by little. I always, you know, I try to tell my friends and my family na, if I could go back in time, I would do everything the same. But I'm lying to them. I'm just trying to tell them what they want to hear, you know, things to make them feel better. Because if I did have a time machine, I would do it completely different.
It has shaped you, molded you, taught you, diba? Humbled you.
Yeah, that's the number one thing it did. Talaga. And I think I needed that for sure. Definitely needed that.
So what are you looking forward now sa buhay mo, Albi?
The number one thing I'm looking forward to is like when creating my own content. Mm. So first will be like the Kumu things. Albi Casino and Kumu, follow your boy.
Okay.
Plug lang. And I also have a YouTube channel, which I have a little podcast also that goes. So Albi Casino on YouTube, check out Stallion Talk.
Yes.
So I'm excited to do that.
Ano yung isang bagay naman na you're grateful for ngayon?
Now I'm grateful for all of the love that I'm getting. It feels so good, man.
They like me now.
They like me now. I'm not even pretending to be anyone that I'm not. Diba? Mm. Like, they actually like me for who I am. So.
The greatest lesson you learned about love?
Siguro, like, that love isn't about loving a perfect person. You know, like when before I would think, oh, she's perfect for me. But we're so perfect for each other. But, like, it's about loving an imperfect person perfectly.
Max talaga nga on the maturity. Okay, the greatest lesson naman that you learned in showbiz. So 12 years na nasa showbiz ka.
That no matter how bad or how low you feel you are, that you can always keep going if you want to. Because like I said, about the ADHD, it wants you to jump it. It wants to
skip
go.
Skip the steps.
Yeah, skip the steps. I want to go from point A to point B. But it's not about going from point A to point B. It's about moving your feet one at a time until you get to point B. So who knows how long that's gonna take?
The greatest lesson naman you learned from your mom.
That's the greatest lesson I learned from my mom is that no matter what I do, no matter how bad I mess up, no matter how bad I screw up, my mom's gonna love me unconditionally. So I can always fall back on her for all of these things.
Kasi parang talagang your mom has been your defender, warrior.
So like I just imagine
the frontliner.
Yeah, she is. And I just imagine if that was taking a toll on me like that, what was it doing to her? Diba?
It killed her.
For sure, multiple times, more than once. And it's all because I didn't listen to her. You know what I mean?
So yun siguro ang message mo sa mga kabataan.
Oh,
listen to your parents. Sa mga 18-year-old Albies na nanonood sa atin ngayon.
I promise, man, listen to your mom. They have that intuition, bro. It's real. The mother's intuition, that's a true thing. Thank you.